Hello, welcome to a Wednesday morning edition of Mornings with Stanley. Just got back from our prayer group and then a walk. Only four of us there this morning in our prayer group. One, two are out of town, two just slept in. And we had breakfast on a bun from Whataburger. Very good breakfast. I even had some to share with the dogs. I hope that's not too bad a thing. I don't do it all that often. But I was in charge of breakfast today, so. Got my sleeve on, my new compression sleeve that's supposed to help my elbow. We'll see. I haven't worked out in 2 days, or since, I guess, Saturday, so. It actually hurt more this morning than it did had for a while, so I don't know what's up with that. I don't think I lifted anything unusual. Anyway, I'm gonna kick Stanley out. Lucy was in here a minute. I don't know if you saw her head. But I'm gonna kick Stanley out of the room. Here comes Lucy. She's walking this way. Let's see if she's coming back in here. She heard her name. She is turning the corner. She's hanging on. She's coming in. Stanley doesn't like it when Lucy gets attention. Okay, I'm going to kick you out. Stanley is... His tail is causing damage. Okay, Lucy, you want to stay or you want to go? You can go. Okay. Anyway, we are in Wednesday of week 46. In Christ by E. Stanley Jones. I think we're going through first or second, first Peter still. Wednesday, peace in Christ Jesus. Peace to all of you that are in Christ. That's 1 Peter 5:14. This may seem a mere greeting as we say salam, peace in India, but it may mean more. It may mean that all those who are in Christ have peace. Note the all. Is being in Christ to be in a state of peace? Is it a special peace different from anything the world calls peace? Yes, Jesus said, peace I leave you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled. Neither let them be afraid. That's John 14:27. Is there a peace called my peace? Is it different, profoundly different from the psychological peace called peace of mind? Yes. A friend, deeply disturbed, had an operation in which a portion of the front part of his brain, the troubled part, was severed. He now has peace of mind, but it is the peace of indifference. That is one kind of peace, peace at a price of personality. Another kind of peace is a peace of tranquilizers, deadening of disturbed centers with drugs. This too is peace at a price, the price of aliveness. There is a peace of stimulants. A chaplain said he could not preach unless he had a drink of liquor beforehand. This is peace, the peace of a false world of stimulation. Another is a peace of mental assertion that there is nothing to fear. This is peace, the peace of illusion. Another is a peace that comes from remembering that a reward in heaven awaits. This is the peace of pie in the sky. Then there is the peace of Christ. It is a piece of adequacy, a piece of assurance that you are adequate for anything, for you can not only bear everything, but can use everything that comes, good, bad, or indifferent. This is a peace without illusions. It says pain, sorrow, sickness, and death are real. There is a reality within within that faces this reality without and transforms it into character and achievement, hence peace. Good word for today. Here's our prayer. Oh Jesus, Lord and Master of this business of life, I thank you for your secret, the secret of your peace. You walked up to the cross and made evil contribute, made it redemptive. Teach me your secret, then I shall know your peace. Amen. And our affirmation for the day, I shall have no pseudo peace. It shall be the peace of reality. All else lets me down. Jesus is Lord.